Morning children, welcome to another English class of grammar in which we are going to learn the order of adjectives. What is an adjective, children? The describing words for a noun are called as adjectives. And when we want to describe something, we can use more than one adjective. Okay? So here, when we consider when three girls are there, you can describe them as the three beautiful young girls. The three beautiful young girls. Okay, you can write like this or how to write. This is the first option. The second one is the beautiful three young girls. The third option is the young beautiful your understanding that I am giving an example. So here we can see that girls are described in three beautiful young. So here three adjectives are used. Three adjectives are used and these three adjectives are interchanged and the order of the adjectives is being changed. Now how to know which is the proper way of arranging or of writing the adjectives? Today we are going to learn how to decide the order of the adjectives. There's a simple way for remembering. I am going to teach you the shortcut, or you call it as the acronym. First of all, we are going to learn what is the acronym, what are their full forms, and then what comes under the particular heading. This is all what we are going to learn today. So let's begin our class learning the order of adjectives. So the acronym is denotes as form. D knows as form. Denotes as form. Repeat after me, children. Denotes as form. Denotes as form. Now let us see what are the full forms. D is a determiner. D means determiner. D is determiner. N is number. O is opinion or quality. Opinion or quality. S is size. A is age. S is shape. Denotes as comb. C. C is a color. O is the origin. O is the origin. M is the material. Then P is the purpose. Material, P is the purpose. Understood this, children? In your textbook, they have clubbed 2-3 of them into one group and they have given. But till your 10th class, this is the proper order of adjectives. How to decide which adjective is going to come? The proper order is this. Denotes as form. D means determiner. D, no, N. N is the number. O is, what is O? Yes? Very good. Opinion or quality. Denotes S. S is the size. Then denotes as A. A is the age. S is the shape. Then C is color. O is origin. M is material. And P is the purpose. Understood all this? Now let us discuss what each one will contain. D is the determiner. In the determiners, you will have the articles. Articles. What are articles? A and the. These are the articles which come under determiners. The first part in this is articles, which is A and the. Then the next one is possessives. Possessive. Possessive means my, mine, yours, your, his, her, our, its. All these are possessives. For this determiners, the first thing that you have is articles. Articles are a and the. Then possessives. Quantifier. What is the next one? Quantifier. Quantifiers are some, several, many. All these are quantifiers. Articles, possessives, quantifiers. What are quantifiers? Some, several, many, all. All these are quantifiers. What is the last one? Demonstratives. In demonstratives, you have this, that, these, those. All these are demonstratives. The first one, determiners. In determiners, we have some more parts in determiners. All the articles, that is A and the, they are determiners. Possessives, your, mine, mine, their, all these are possessives. Quantifiers means some, several, many, all. All these come under determiners. Demonstratives, this, that, those, all these are demonstratives. That means for a sentence, if you have a, or if you have the, if you have an, all these will come first because they are articles. The first preference will be given to these things. Understood? If you have bag or that, red bag, something like that, that, this, all these, whatever we have discussed, if they are there, they will be given the first preference. The order is first for the determiners. In determiners, we have four. The first one is article, second one is possessives, then you have the quantifiers and then demonstratives. Quantifiers and demonstratives. Understood this first part? D we have finished. The next one is number. Numbers are of two types. One is cardinal numbers and the second one is ordinal numbers. Cardinal numbers means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that. The normal numbers, all of them, they come under cardinal numbers. What are ordinal numbers? Ordinal numbers are 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th. All these are ordinal numbers. Understood the difference? If you have cardinal numbers 1, 2, 3, in the previous example we were speaking about 3 girls. 3 is a number and it is a cardinal number, so first preference is given to that. Understood? The next one is opinion or quality. Opinion means what you feel or what you think about something. Okay, for example, if you see a person, you think that she is beautiful, you use the word beautiful girl. Beautiful girl. Beautiful is going to be the opinion, or pleasant, beautiful, ugly. All these are the opinions which you have about something or somebody. Okay, the next one is size. Small, short, tall, long, all these are sizes. They are speaking about the sizes. So, sizes will be given the fourth preference. Next, age. It is, age means young, old, then new. These are the terms which are used for age. Okay, young, old, new, all these are used for age. This is going to be given the fifth place. Age is given its fifth place. The next part is S, that is shape. Rectangular shape, triangular shape. Now you can see this. Can you see this, children? You can see that this is which shape? This is a square shaped object. Okay, square shape. Then if you see the duster, look at the duster, which shape is this? This is a rectangular object. So the shape of the objects, if you take, that is going to have the next preference after the age. The next part is color, black, white, grey, pink, purple, all the colors will be given the preference after the shape. The next one is origin. Origin means from where the noun has come. For example, Indian, Chinese, Italian, those are the origins from where the object has come. Okay, if you are using a China phone, this is a Chinese phone. Okay, the origin is from China. Understood? The next one is material. Material means silk, cotton, like that. If material is given, wooden, like that, material will be given last but one preference. Then the last preference is given to the purpose. For example, for what the noun is being used. For example, if you have a spoon, why do you use it? We use it for cooking. Your mother will be cooking rice, no? She's going to use the spoon for cooking. So it is used for cooking. Okay, cooking, fishing, whatever purpose we are using the noun, that comes, that is given the least preference. Understood this, children? Now let us revise once again. What is the acronym, children? Denotes as form. What is the acronym? Repeat again. Okay, D means determiner. Very good. In determiners we have four. What are they? Articles, possessives, quantifiers, and what is the fourth one? Demonstratives. Demonstratives is the fourth one. Then after D we have N. N is a number. Two types of numbers. What are they? Cardinal numbers, ordinal numbers. Then after numbers O, opinion. Opinion is pleasant, beautiful, lovely, fantastic, terrible. All these come under the opinions. Then you have S. S is the size. Short, tall, huge, all these come under the size. Then denotes as A, age. New, old, young, all these come under the age. After age, A, S. S is the shape. Rectangular shape, triangular shape, then square shaped, all these come under shapes. Then after that, what do you have? Denotes as form. C. C is the color. Color of the object, you can tell. Color. Then you have O. O is for origin. Then after that you have M. What is M? M is for material. What material is used? The noun is made up of which material? That is material. Then the next part is P. P is the purpose. Purpose for using the noun. What is a noun first? It is the name of a person, place, animal or thing. Understood all this, children? Very good. Now let me write the example which we have used earlier. The three beautiful young girls. So several options were there, but let us see whether this is the right one. The, it comes under the determiner. So it is proper. Then three is a number, so number is proper. Then beautiful is given, that is an opinion. So O is finished. Young, so here age is given, so young is also correct. So this is the perfect order of using the adjectives, of using more than two or three adjectives. Understood this, children? Okay. So now we are going to go through the textual exercises which are given in your text. Then open your textbooks to page number 96, grammar. Adjectives and their order in a phrase. Look at the following sentences from the reading passage. Usha was a tiny village girl. She was an extremely bright student. So as you already know, let us write the acronym so that it is easy for you to decide. Denotes as form. Denotes as form. This is the order. So here tiny. Tiny is the size. So size then tiny village. Village is the origin. So these two, is it in the proper order? Yes, it is correct. She was extremely bright student. Okay, extremely. Extremely is an opinion which is given. Bright. Bright also is an adjective. Extremely bright student. Now let us see page number 97. The underlined words are adjectives. They describe Usha. We may use more than one adjective to describe a person, place or thing or an object. They may give us information about things like quality, color, age, make. Make means material, shape, etc. of a person, place, thing or an object. Okay. Now, order of adjectives is the heading which is given. When we use two or more adjectives to describe a noun, we have to take care of their order. The position of the adjective depends on how closely they are related to the noun. Though hard and fast rules cannot be given, the following guidelines will be of some help. Okay, so here's a usual order which is given. But the order which I have shown you previously, copy that order in your classwork books. Okay, that is very useful for you till your 10th class. Okay, now let us look at the example. It is Rani's beautiful, old, brown, Indian, handmade wooden table. So here, beautiful is the opinion, old is the age, brown the color, Indian is the origin, handmade, that is the material, handmade, wooden. Here past participle is also given, but this also will come under the material. Handmade wooden, you can use it for the material only. Understood this, children? Now what we have to do is rewrite the following sentences with the correct order of adjectives. So let us do Roman number 1. Usha was born at farm. Mother sold her house. So let us rearrange this. What is the correct answer, children?
Correct answers. Only answers I am writing. Usha was born. Copy this in your classwork books, children. Copy the question as well as the answer. Usha was born at her mother's house, old farmhouse. Understood, children? This is the proper order. Let us write the second one. We are writing only the answers. To copy the complete question and then write the answers. This is the first answer. Now the second one. Usha is dark, little, a shy girl. What is dark? It is the color. Little is the size. S, shy is the opinion. So let us rearrange it. Usha is a shy, little, dark girl. Usha is a shy little dark girl. Understood, children? Now the next one is, there are flowers, some beautiful, rose, white, in our garden. So rearrange this. Beautiful is the opinion. White is the color. Rose, what is rose? It is also an adjective. So let us rearrange that. There are some beautiful white rose flowers in our garden. Let us write the answer. There are beautiful, some beautiful white rose flowers in our garden. There are some beautiful white rose flowers in our garden. Understood this? Copy. Let us read the next one. It is new.
my textbook English. Let's rearrange that. It is my new English textbook. Fourth answer is, it is my new English. English E will be capital. English textbook. Understood, children? It is my new English textbook. Then the last one is, Sunita was dressed in sari, Kanchipuram, expensive and silk. So you have to rearrange this. Sunita was dressed in an expensive Kanchipuram silk sari. Let us write the fifth answer. Sunita was dressed in an expensive Kanchipuram A is missing in the textbook. Kanchipuram silk sari. Sunita was dressed in an expensive Kanchipuram silk sari. Understood this, children? Okay. Roman number 2 we are going to do in the next class. Now, hope all of you have understood how to order the adjectives. Did you understand, children? Very good. Complete the work in the class workbook. Write the acronym, and I have drawn and written all that you are supposed to write, and after that you are going to do the exercise in your class workbooks.